The National Solidarity Program is local, and I think that with a country like Afghanistan, the localization of a lot of these efforts will probably be more long-term in its impact, and also will really generate, you know, points of democracy where people are making decisions for themselves that's particular to the area. When you have 22,000 across 34 provinces, and they become very workable models, and countries recognize that, that's something that we should be looking at and promoting. And I think it's about 9,000 more CDCs that we can establish.
CDCs are community development councils, mixed
right.
gender, democratic relatively, and so on. How are those allowed to function? I mean, the picture we get of Afghanistan is of warlords and power structures who would want to step in the way of things like this, who wouldn't allow them to be mixed gender and so on, and yet they do seem to be flourishing.
They flourish because they are local, and when local folks get together and they know what's good for them and what it is that they want to see, they can resist or they can counter the kind of influence that warlords would have. And, you know, the warlords depend upon, I guess, the accumulation of the different community groups to have maintain their control. But when people are happy and they're realizing self-determination, that's a big difference in the way we're approaching Afghanistan right now.
A lot of that money that
we're investing in there should be staying there and be invested in the people there, and they shouldn't be going out of the country with the benefit of the people there. You know, it should stay there.
So not channeled through U.S. aid and contractors and so forth.
That's correct.
Doesn't all of this, though, fly in the face of General McChrystal's counterinsurgency strategy, which, if we were to understand it correctly, is to have a few towns which are sort of armed to the teeth with the U.S. military, and then flood it with development aid through U.S. aid and U.S. contractors and so on. Aren't you advocating something entirely different, Afghan-wide and local?
Well, that seems to be General McChrystal's approach to where he sees the problem and how he wants to address it, and then leave the rest of the country to USAID. What I'm saying is that we should go more to the grassroots and depend upon more of the grassroots and us being more supportive. McChrystal's identification of the hotspots may be correct, but I think the way we address the hotspots could be approached differently.